You're watching UNICEF television. Haitian boys play football on a pitch once graced by some of the greatest players in the world. But this is hardly a dream come true. For many, this is a nightmare. 3 weeks after a devastating earthquake rocked the capital, Port-au-Prince, hundreds of thousands of people are now living in makeshift camps across the city, including this one at the Stade Silvio Cator, the national football stadium. While they were lucky enough to survive the quake, the fear is they may not survive the camps. Conditions are rife for the spread of disease. But UNICEF and partners have launched a massive immunization campaign. Working with the Haitian Ministry of Health, WHO and others, the campaign will target children under 7, but will also cater to the immunization needs of older children and even adults.
You know, a lot of displaced people from other areas are coming into the football stadium and it's getting extremely congested. So we thought that would be an obvious place to target. It's also right in the middle of town. So there are displaced people around it who would be encouraged to come there to receive vaccination as well. Of course, we target the settlements, but we are not going to refuse vaccination to anybody who comes to the vaccination post.
The campaign will then move on to other camps in the capital before being extended to other quake-affected areas throughout the country.
I was cooking on the roof when the earthquake happened. I covered my two smallest children with my body, but my other two children were in the house and I couldn't save them. I was only dug out of the rubble at 3 a.m. I came here to vaccinate my remaining two children because I don't want them to be sick. I want them to survive.
For Magali, her kids, and those like her who have made it through the quake but have lost everything, who are now living in makeshift shelters in overcrowded camps, the fight to survive is not yet over. But UNICEF, together with the international community, is committed to making sure they do survive and are able to start rebuilding their lives. This is Guy Hubbard, reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.